skilling and the getting higher education and the skilling. The biggest challenge today in the skill side is that it is not progressive. It is providing them certifications but not letting them move up on the skill value chain. So one of the biggest things that today youngsters responded in the survey was that they want such programs which gives them progression in the future. So we have a huge network of ITIs, but how do we create ITIs as a finishing, as a school, as a skill school, and it becomes a feeder school to universities is something that this university is also looking at. The another feedback that people, the youngsters, gave across the state was that more than 80% of these youngsters are wanting to have programs in an earn and learn model. The respondents want that they want to go for learning, but the learning should have the components of earning also incorporated into it. More than 72% youngsters who wanted to go for qualifications are saying that they want programs which have an OJT element baked into it. And we heard Mr. T.C. Gupta talking about the apprenticeship model that we have today in the country and how that needs to be leveraged. The another good information that we have had through the surveys was that almost 76% of the females, diversity respondents, were saying that they are ready to relocate for the purpose of skilling and employment, which is also a very good input because the state has a huge diversity workforce, and if the opportunities are created for them, we can really leverage this potential for the growth of the state. Vishwakarma Skill University, in last couple of weeks, the effort that the team has done, we have signed almost 32 MOUs with various corporates, industries, institutions, as well as organizations, and the intent is that these MOUs are taken where we integrate the apprenticeship learning with the vocational learning, on-the-job learning with the vocational learning, classroom learning.